In this video, we'll discuss nerve injuries. There are 3 degrees of nerve injuries: mild, moderate, and severe. Mild is neuropraxia, moderate is axonotomesis, and severe is neurotomesis. Let's discuss neuropraxia, the mild form of nerve injury. Pressure, compression, or stretch injury. Distraught myelin sheath over nodes of Ranvier without Wallerian degeneration, but with preservation of axis cylinder of myelin sheath. So this damage of the myelin sheath at the node of Ranvier produces conduction block, and this conduction block causes numbness in the extremities. There is profound motor loss in neuropraxia with minimal sensory loss. Recovery occurs in few days to few weeks. So in neuropraxia, there is numbness due to conduction block, and myelin sheath is distorted at nodes of Ranvier without Wallerian degeneration. The conduction block causes numbness. The second degree, or the moderate degree of nerve injury, axonotomesis, there is demyelination that causes axonal damage that leads to loss of continuity of axon. There is Wallerian degeneration distal to the lesion, but with preservation of Schwann cells and endonerium in axonotomesis. There is complete motor loss with some sensory loss, but spontaneous regeneration and recovery occurs, but it takes a while. So in axonotomesis, there is demyelination and axonal damage with Wallerian degeneration distal to the lesion, but with preservation of Schwann cells and endonerium. The severe form of nerve injury is neurotomesis, in which axons, Schwann cells, and endonerium are completely distorted or disrupted, and there is complete motor and sensory loss. A spontaneous recovery does not occur in neurotomesis. So how do you differentiate between neuropraxia, axonotomesis, and neurotomesis? Nerve conduction studies differentiate between the 3 conditions, but it should be delayed for 3 weeks if nerve injury is due to trauma, compression, stretch, or pressure. If it's neuropraxia, then it will recover and function will return. So in neuropraxia, function returns and 80% of the close injury resolves spontaneously. And if after 3 months there is loss of function and EMG shows no motor unit, then it's neurotomesis. So exploration and surgical repair should be done. So in neurotomesis, there is loss of function after 3 months and EMG shows no motor units. So appearance of a tunnel sign indicates that the nerve is in continuity. So surgery should be postponed. Tunnel sign is an important neurological test, and we'll discuss it later in another video. The nerve regeneration rate is 2.5 cm per month, or 1 millimeter per day, or 1 inch per month, but it depends on the degree of nerve damage. Diagnosis is done by MRI, ultrasound, nerve conduction velocity study, and EMG.